Welcome to the course of Artificial Intelligence. Myself, Professor Satish, is going to teach this particular elective subject for final year students of Electronics and Telecommunication program. So, in this particular lecture, we are going to cover the fundamentals of Artificial Intelligence, various applications, and we are going to cover a little historical background of AI. Now let us come back to these points. Artificial intelligence, it is a very popular word nowadays. In this particular word, we can find the two words, artificial and intelligence. In short, it is also called as AI. What exactly the artificial intelligence is? It means we want the machine to have the intelligence just like humans. Means human can think, reason, learn, take decisions whether to go for this way or this way. Such decisions human being can do. Human being can also solve the problems. Human being can also play the games. Okay, so we also need to have intelligent entities which can behave like a human. So in order to do that, we need to put intelligence, artificial intelligence in those machines to behave them like a human being. This particular concept is nothing but artificial intelligence. Means we want to add intelligence in the machines artificially. This total theory is called as AI theory. Now, if we observe the syllabus of this AI subject, we will find, as usual, there are 6 units, and the exam pattern also you know. Exam pattern consists of 30 marks for in semester examination and 70 marks for end semester examination as per the university norms. As usual, there are 6 units. Unit number 1 is foundation, unit number 2 is searching, unit number 3 is knowledge representation, unit number 4 is learning, unit number 5 is pattern recognition and expert system, and the last is natural language processing. Now what exactly these units are? In the unit number 1, we are going to learn key concepts such as intelligent agents, nature of environment, searching for solution. So what exactly this intelligent agent is? Intelligent agent means you want to make a machine, you want to build or design a machine or robot who can think like a human being. Who can think like a human being. Okay? Such a machine or robot or program is called an intelligent agent. So what are the types of intelligent agents? How to build or design that intelligent agents? What kind of environment are there in front of agent? Whether the environment is fully observable or partially observable, etc. That we are going to study in this particular point. Then searching for solution is also a key point in unit number 1. Searching for solution means if that particular intelligent agent you design, then if that particular agent want to solve certain problem, then which are the various techniques, which are the searching strategies to find the solution. Okay, so there are 2 key searching strategies in the syllabus. Those are uninformed search and informed search. So these are the key points of unit number 1. That means, in short, we are going to study the fundamentals of intelligent agents, the types of environment in which the agent work, which are the searching strategy for the agents to obtain the final solution. So strategies are uninformed search and informed search. Uninformed search means the agent do not have additional knowledge of environment. That means it do not have any additional knowledge or additional information. That is why it is called as uninformed search. And informed search means apart from the domain knowledge, this intelligent agent do have some additional information to find out the solution. That's why such a techniques are called as informed search. Okay, so this is all about from unit number 1. So what you need to remember, you need to remember that you are going to learn the fundamentals of intelligent agents in unit number 1, environment and searching strategies. Before going to the details of unit number 2, let us concentrate on this part of this board. What exactly AI, where the AI started? Now today is 2020, so where exactly the AI started in the historic history? In World War II, during World War II, means around 1945, all we know the Germans were fighting with the other countries. So one scientist, Alan Turing, wanted to break the communications of Germany. Then that's why he tried something new, and he tried to put some intelligence into the machine, and that is why the artificial intelligence, that gave the birth to the artificial intelligence. This Alan Turing, he published a paper in a conference in 1950. That conference was very, very popular, Data Mouth conference. In that particular conference, Alan Turing published a paper, Can Machine Think? And the whole world started thinking in this direction. Can machine think like a human being? Human being can think, human being can solve the problems, human being can reason, human being can take the decisions, human being can perform the actions. So in the same direction, the Alan Turing was thinking whether all these traits of human being, can it be put into machines? That's why the conference, he gave the title to this particular paper, Can Machine Think? And the whole world started thinking in this particular direction. Now what is the state of art of this artificial intelligence? State of art, you can find, I have noted down some examples. Smartphone, for example. In smartphone, we all know that there is Google Assistant, or in Apple phones you will find Siri. What exactly this Google Assistant do? When whatever we want to find out, the information of some particular point we want to find out, we just speak in front of that smartphone with the help, and then Google Assistant understand that particular our query and try to find out the solution. Within the fractions of second, it gives you the solution. Okay, that means in this particular example, we generally speak, speak some keyword, and Google Assistant straight away immediately gives you the possible solution for that particular query. Okay, this all is possible with the help of natural language processing, and natural language processing is a part of AI. Natural language processing means this particular app, Google Assistant app, in the background, artificial intelligence works in this Google Assistant. It tried to understand the natural language spoken by the person and tried to find out the solution. The second example I can give you is the autonomous cars designed by Tesla company. Tesla company designed autonomous cars, or it also called as driverless cars or smart cars. There are more than 50,000 smart cars nowadays in Arizona part of US. These autonomous cars are driverless cars, means AI is working in the background of those cars, and those cars moves on the roads of Arizona state, and there may be some obstacles, there may be traffic jams. So if some car is facing some problem in a particular road, if it wants to go to certain destination and some jam is there or some rally is there, then automatically the machine in that particular car gives this information to the central machine of Tesla. That machine is handling all the 50,000 cars, and automatically the machine created by Tesla, AI machine created by Tesla, provide this particular information to all the rest of the cars. That means one car is going from one place to the other place, and that particular car is selecting some way or route, And for example, on that route, certain jams are there, some rallies are there, some obstacles are there. So automatically that car gives this information, very useful information to machine, okay, of Tesla, and then that machine will provide this information to the rest of the cars, all remaining cars. Therefore, remaining cars, if they want to go to the same destination from the same starting point, then these cars will avoid this particular route. They will go to their destination by some another way. It is possible just because of the information given by that particular car. So this particular concept also uses the artificial intelligence. Here also Google Assistant also uses artificial intelligence with the help of NLP, it solves the problem. Then we also find in day-to-day life Netflix. It is also, this working of this Netflix is also based on AI. For example, the user many times searches some topics or concepts on YouTube, and if they go on searching day by day certain topic, then automatically your searching history is stored in the Netflix machine, which is based on AI. Then next time whenever you start your YouTube, that time you will find some advertise or some recommendations, your recommendations appear on the right hand side of your YouTube screen. It points out that there is some another video of this particular domain which you may be interested in. This is the concept of working behind the Netflix. That means it gives you the recommendation that you can go for this video also, which is related with your domain of interest. This Netflix is also based on AI. So online pizza order, for example, this concept is also going on in Western countries. For example, some person online book for pizza online, and automatically they find that the one message appears on his screen that there is your cholesterol level is high, don't go for this particular pizza order. Okay. But next time again he applies for that pizza, then again the next message comes next time that your cholesterol level is this 50 or 60, like this. Okay. Again, if the person again does the same mistake again in the on the next day or after some time, then this particular machine will automatically remove the particular pizza from the catalog list for that particular machine. So how it happened? It may be happened because of that the history of that particular person, the medical history of that particular person is available to some server, and through that server this company or the machine obtain that particular information and then takes the particular decision. So all these autonomous machines works on the concepts of AI. That means what exactly these machines does? These machines, just like it can be a machine, it can be a robot, it can be a program, it tries to mimic the human being, tries to copy the human being. So what it wants to copy? It wants to copy the human traits such as reasoning ability, learning ability, perception, problem solving ability of the human being. So AI, what exactly AI does? AI try to fill up this gap between person, human being and machine. Human being and machine. So AI tries to make a machine who can work, think and solve the problems like human being. This is what the role of AI is. So what exactly the recent trends in AI? The recent trends in AI are to make the machines which can solve the problems of which the human being cannot do. We can find there are various IT giants are now started working in AI direction, such as Google, such as Google, then Apple is there, then Tesla is there, and so many companies are working in this direction. They are putting lot of fund in AI for R&D work to make the human life easier. So these are the recent trends, and machine learning, AI, deep learning, all these concepts are useful in today's era. That means there is a very lot of scope is there in machine learning, AI and deep learning. Okay, all these are the based on AI, artificial intelligence. Now let us come back to our syllabus of artificial intelligence. Here you will find unit number 1 is foundation, in which you are going to learn few key concepts, that intelligent agent, how to design the intelligent agent, what are the types of environment in which the agent work. Agent means what? Agent can be a machine, it can be a robot, it can be a program. Okay, so how to design that program which can work in an intelligent manner just like human being. Okay, so all these concepts we are going to study in unit number 1. Second unit is searching. So whenever some machine you create or design, what exactly the objective behind that? Obviously you want to search for some solution which you want to do autonomously, or you want to solve some problems. Obviously if you want to make some machine, then that machine you want to solve particular problem, so there must be some strategies, searching strategy to find out the solution, in what manner the machine can solve the problem, search the solution of the given problem. That is called as search strategy or searching methods or searching techniques. So which are the searching techniques? The searching techniques for the solutions are uninformed search, informed search. Who is going to do this search? Obviously agent. Which agent? Intelligent agent. Intelligent agent can be, it can be a machine, it can be a robot, it can be a program, computer program. So this is all about from unit number 1. Unit number 2 covers few fundamental concepts of informed search strategy. There are 5 to 6 types of informed search strategy. There are 4 to 5 types of uninformed search strategy. We will cover this in the coming lectures. Okay, and apart from informed search strategy, we are also going to study the concept of constraint satisfaction problem. Constraint satisfaction problem in unit number 2. Constraint satisfaction problem means what? There are some constraints, means machine is doing the solving the problem, but many times there are some constraints that your machine should not go to this particular room. Okay, for example, you are having vacuum cleaner machine, autonomous vacuum cleaner machine or dirt cleaner machine. Okay, so dirt cleaner machine will do what? Dirt cleaner machine, if it is started, then it will suck the dirt. Okay, suck the dirt. But suppose I give some constraint that the machine should not suck the dirt from 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. in the morning. Okay, that means I am giving some constraint to that machine. Okay, I am giving some rules to that machine. Okay, such a problems are called as constraint satisfaction problems. So machine should also solve the problem such as constraint satisfaction problem. For example, the example of your vacuum cleaner, I can give another constraint to this vacuum cleaner. For example, I give the constraint such as the vacuum cleaner should clean only room number A. It should not clean room number B. Okay, if this constraint is given then, and if I design such intelligent agent vacuum cleaner, then automatically this vacuum cleaner will follow this constraint. Okay, such a problems are called as constraint satisfaction problems. For such problems, intelligent agents are to be designed by the AI researchers. It is the role of researcher to design the agents depending upon the problem. The problem can be moderate, or it can be on lower side than CSP. It can be a CSP problem, or it can be a much complex than CSP. It depends on problem. According to that, the machine should be, intelligent agent should be created. Then unit number 3 is knowledge representation. What exactly knowledge representation means? Knowledge representation means until and unless you have knowledge, the human being cannot perform the work. Okay, if the knowledge is there, then and then only much human being can do the take the decisions, understand something, reasoning, do the reasoning. For example, if some particular person is on the 20th floor of the building, he is on the terrace of some building, and whether to jump from that 20th floor on the ground or not, how this particular decision is to be, the human being can take decision. Human being can learn that if I jump from the 20th floor, then I will be not there, I will be, I will be finished. Okay, so it takes the decision that what is the height of that, means it takes the knowledge, it can learn from the previous history that some person is jumped from this floor, then his life is lost. So here also, if I jump from this particular 20th floor, my life may get lost. So that's why I should not jump. Okay, this is an intelligent decision taken by human being. Even though the person has this particular knowledge, then also if he jumps, that means he has not taken the perfect decision. That means he is not intelligent person. Okay, so all such decisions are possible just because of knowledge. Okay, because person, the human being, has that knowledge that from this height, if I jump, I will lose my life. This knowledge that person have, that is why he took the decision not to jump. Similarly, such a knowledge we want the machine should have. Okay, so so it is the role of AI researchers to give the knowledge to that machine. Machine means what? Intelligent agent. Agent can be machine, robot, or a program. So it is the role of AI researchers to give the knowledge, relevant knowledge. Okay, relevant knowledge of the given problem. Okay, what problem is there? What is the role of that machine? For what problem you designed that machine? Okay, if a certain problem is there that you want to make a autonomous car, then what is the problem? How many roads are there? How many obstacles are there? Okay, where is the brake? Where is the accelerator? Where is the ignition switch? All this knowledge must be given to the intelligent agent in that particular autonomous car. Then and then only that intelligent car can move ahead. Okay, so knowledge